Hi students, are you scared of Bayes' theorem? Do you feel that the Bayes' theorem is very difficult? Then listen to this class. Believe me, after listening to this class, you will start solving problems on Bayes' theorem and you can solve them in seconds. In this lecture, we will going to learn the definition of partition of S, theorem of total probability and a problem supporting the theorem, and the Bayes' theorem and a problem supporting the Bayes' theorem. Let us begin the class with the definition of partition of S. Let us consider a set S, but since we are studying on the probability, that set S can be taken as the sample space. Let this rectangle represent the sample space S. We will going to partition this sample space S into a number of subsets or sub events. Let us break this down. Let this be the event E1, this be event E2, and so on up to En. Here we have subdivisions of E3, E4 and so on. Depending on n, we will going to split this sample space into a number of sub collections. This collection P is equal to Ei, where I runs from 1 to n, is said to be the partition of S if it satisfies these two conditions. One is that when we take the union of these sub events, we have to get S, the entire sample space, that is union Ei, where I runs from 1 to n is equal to S. And when we take two different events, then their intersection should not contain any element in common. So Ei intersection Ej is equal to null for I not equal to j. This is the partition of S. Now, let us move on to the theorem of total probability. We have a sample space S. This denotes the sample space S. And we divide this sample space into the partition E1, E2 and so on up to En. Let us do that. This is the event E1, E2 and so on, En. This is the event En. Now we have another event A, which is overlapping with all these sub events. Let this be the event A, which is overlapping with all these events E1, E2 and so on up to En. It has intersection with each and every sub events. This area represents A intersection E1. This area represents A intersection E2. And this area represents A intersection En. If we want to find the probability of occurrence of event A, then we have to sum up all these intersection parts. We know a result P of A given E1 is P of A intersection E1 divided by P of E1. Now I want the intersection probability. So I will simplify this for P of A intersection E1, that will going to be P of E1 into P of A given E1. So P of A intersection E1 is written as P of E1 into P of A given E1. So similarly, we will write the expression for P of A intersection E2 and so on up to P of A intersection En. And we have to sum up all these probabilities to get P of A, right? So we sum up P of A intersection E1, this is P of A intersection E1, this is P of A intersection E2, and so on. We have this is P of A intersection EN. Writing this in a compact form, we have summation j runs from 1 to n P of EJ into P of A given EJ. Now see the definition of the theorem of total probability. Let E1, E2 and so on up to EN be a partition of the sample space S, and suppose that each of the events E1, E2 up to EN has non-zero probability of occurrence. Let A be an event associated with S, then P of A is P of A intersection E1, P of A intersection E2 plus and so on up to plus P of A intersection EN. This can be written as P of E1 into P of A given E2 plus P of E2 into P of A given E2 plus and so on up to P of EN into P of A given EN. And this is the compact form. We will solve a problem on theorem of total probability for the better understanding of the concept. A person has undertaken a construction job. The probabilities are 0.65 that there will be a strike, 0.80 that the construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike, and 0.32 that the construction job will be completed on time if there is a strike. Determine the probability that the construction job will be completed on time. Here, the person who is undertaking the construction job has to face two types of situations and he has to complete his construction job. What are the two situations? Think of it. One is the strike. Another is that there is no strike. So, when we take the construction of job as the sample space, then we have divided that job into a strike and a non-strike as the subsets. Let this rectangle denote the sample space S. Since we have two situations, strike and no strike, we will divide this sample space into two subsets. One is event B and another is having no strike, is the complement of B. So, it is taken as B complement. Now, come back to the problem. It is given that the probabilities are 0.65 that there will be a strike. So, P of B is 0.65 and P of B and B dash are independent events. So, P of B dash is 1 minus P of B, which is 1 minus 0.65, that is equal to 0.35. The person will complete the construction job under both the situations. So, if we let event A as the event that the construction job will be completed on time, then this circle, which is overlapping in both the situations, is the event that represents the construction job will be completed on time. This region with the green shade represents A intersection B, and this with the orange shade will denote A intersection B dash. It is given that the probability of the construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike is 0.80. If we encode these wordings, the construction job will be completed on time is taken as A, and there is no strike is the event B dash, and the word if can be substituted with the given, then this can be written as A given B dash, and the probability of A given E dash is 0.80, and the probability that the construction job will be completed on time if there is a strike is 0.32. If we encode this wordings, the construction job will be completed on time is taken as event A, and there is a strike is the event B, and we can replace the word if by given, then this represents the event A given B, and the probability of A given B is 0.32. Then easily with the help of the diagram, P of A is P of A intersection B plus P of A intersection B dash. But we don't know what is P of A intersection B and P of A intersection B dash. But we know that P of A intersection B is P of B into P of A given B plus P of B dash into P of A given B dash. We know what is P of B. It is 0.65 into P of A given B is 0.32 plus P of B dash is 0.35 into P of A given B dash is 0.80. If you simplify this, you will going to get it as 0.208 plus 0.28, that is equal to 0.488. Thus, the probability that the construction job will be completed on time is 0.488. You don't need to write all these theory. You just need this diagram to find the probability. Let us move on to the Bayes theorem. Bayes theorem states that if E1, E2 up to EN are N non-empty elements which constitute a partition of a sample space S, when do we say that it is a partition? It has to satisfy the two properties. When we take the union of the events, it should give the entire sample space and they should be pairwise disjoint. And A is any event of non-zero probability, then probability of EI given A is given by this ratio. Now, forget about the Bayes theorem. How do we find the probability of any event E? Suppose this is the sample space, the rectangle represents the sample space, and this is the event E. The probability of event E is given by number of elements in E divided by the number of elements in the sample space. It is the ratio of E and S. Let us extend this to Bayes theorem. This is the sample space S, and we are dividing this into a number of events E1, E2, and so on. Here we have some event EI in between E1 to EN. This is the event EN, and we have an event A which is overlapping with all these events. This area represents A intersection E1. This is A intersection E2. For the ith event, we have A intersection EI. And for the nth event, it is A intersection EN. In the definition of normal probability or usual probability, our frame of reference is the sample space S. Here, we are finding the probability under the reference space A. So now, instead of S, We have to take the entire A, which is the sum of all these intersecting areas that can be splitted as this. Using this definition, P of A given EI is P of A intersection EI divided by P of EI. If we want it for A intersection EI, it is P of EI into P of A given EI. So, if we sum up all the probability of these intersecting areas, it is the summation of this, and we are finding here the probability of EI given A, which means that we are just finding the probability of P of EI, which is this, under the given A. A is the entire this area, which is the probability of A intersection EI, and the sum of this sub areas. Clear? This is how we will view the Bayes theorem diagrammatically. Now we will take one example to understand this better. Bag first contains 3 red and 4 black balls, while another bag second contains 5 red and 6 black balls. One ball is drawn at random from one of the bags and it is found to be red. Find the probability that it was drawn from bag 2. Now we will take the event of drawing a red ball as the event A, and the sample space has 2 bags, bag first and bag second. So this sample space S is partitioned into 2 events. One is of event of getting bag 1 and event of getting bag 2. Let us name this as event E1 and this as event E2. And bag first contains 3 red balls and 4 black balls. And the second bag contains 5 red balls and 6 black balls. So in total, the bag first contains 7 balls and bag second contains 11 balls. Since both the bags contains the red ball, the event of drawing a red ball is an event overlapping on E1 and E2. Back to the problem. One ball is drawn at random from one of the bags and it is found to be red. So we are given that we had already got a red ball. Find the probability that it was drawn from bag 2. So we have to find the probability, given that we had chosen a red ball, and what is the probability that this red ball is drawn from bag 2. We had named the event of getting the ball from bag 2 as E2 and the event of getting red ball as A. So we have to find P of E2 given A. Using the Bayes theorem, what is this? It is this portion which we have to find out with the reference of this entire area, that is P of E2 intersection A divided by P of A, which is nothing but P of E2 into P of A given E2 divided by द सम ऑफ दीज टू इंटरसेक्शंस, दैट इज E1 इंटरसेक्शन ए एंड E2 इंटरसेक्शन ए, दैट कैन बी रिटन एज पी ऑफ E1 इंटू पी ऑफ ए गिवन E1 प्लस पी ऑफ E2 इंटू पी ऑफ ए गिवन E2. Let us find P of E1, P of E2 and P of A given E1, P of A given E2 using the given data. P of E1 is the probability of drawing a ball from bag 1 and P of E2 is the probability of drawing a ball from bag 2. So we have two bags, so probability of drawing a ball from bag 1 is 1 by 2 and P of E2 is also 1 by 2 and P of A given E1 is probability of drawing a red ball from bag 1, which is given by the ratio of number of red balls in bag first divided by the total number of balls in bag first, which is equal to, there are 3 red balls in bag first, so it is 3 divided by the total number of balls in bag 1 is 7. So P of A given E1 is 3 by 7. Similarly, P of A given E2 is the probability of drawing a red ball from bag 2, which is the ratio of number of red balls in bag second divided by total number of balls in bag second, which is equal to bag second has 5 red balls and it has 11 balls, so it is 5 by 11. Now, using the Bayes theorem, we had got that P of E2 given A is P of E2 into P of A given E2 divided by P of E1 into P of A given E1 plus P of E2 into P of A given E2. Now we know all these values. Let us substitute them here. P of E2 is 1 by 2 into 5 by 11 whole divided by 1 by 2 into 3 by 7 plus 1 by 2 into 5 by 11. This is equal to, in the numerator we have